You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India has a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Karim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give you a glimpse of a country's diversity. As the pandemic situation stabilizes, tourism sector in major tourism destinations of India has started to bloom once again. So today we will take you to the beautiful town of Shimla in Himachal Pradesh, which is being flocked by tourists as the country inches towards normalcy. Have a look.
The view of green valleys and hills of Shimla city has the ability to grab eyeballs and leave tourists and visitors mesmerized. The second wave of the COVID-19 pandemic had brought travel and tourism in the country to a standstill. However, now that the situation is under control, with minimal number of COVID-19 cases, tourists have started thronging hill stations like Shimla to beat the summer heat.
This year till 31st of May, we have had about 13 lakh tourists who have visited the state, and in the month of June alone, if I tell you, we have had about 6 to 7 lakh of tourists coming in the month of June, and that is primarily because the COVID protocol restrictions has been eased to an extent, plus also because of the summer being at its peak in the northern part of the country, a lot of tourist inflow has taken place into our state.
Verdant scenery, salubrious weather, snow-clad hills and an old-world charm. Shimla has enticed nature lovers and travel enthusiasts for years. Providing an unparalleled experience to each and everyone visiting the city, the town has something for everyone, like pine forests, urban eateries, lush green grounds and religious temples. Said to be another major attraction of this city, tourists were seen enjoying the toy train ride after a long time.
हमें प्रिकॉशन तो लेना ही है, प्रिकॉशन लेना है, प्रिकॉशन के साथ हमें घूमना है, और कि जिससे इतना प्रॉब्लम भी ना हो, सरकार को भी प्रॉब्लम ना हो, और हिमाचल में तो जैसे ही आया ना, वैसे ही हमारा मतलब कि बता नहीं सकते कितनी खुशी का ठिकाना नहीं है. हमने इतना एंजॉय किया इस टॉय ट्रेन में, मैं तो फर्स्ट टाइम ही बैठी हुई हूं.
सिचुएटेड एट अ हाइट ऑफ 2130 मीटर्स अबव सी लेवल, टेंपरेचर इन दिस हिली टाउन बेयरली क्रॉसेस 25 डिग्री सेल्सियस एंड देयरफॉर हैज बीन अ प्रेफर्ड हॉलिडे डेस्टिनेशन फॉर डोमेस्टिक एज वेल एज फॉरेन टूरिस्ट टू एस्केप द स्कॉर्चिंग हीट.
It has been said that humanity stands above all castes and religions. Exemplifying the term secularism, examples of citizens of different castes and religions helping each other and performing noble gestures could be easily seen in every nook and corner of the country. The similar noble and powerful gesture was recently seen in a small village in Punjab, where members of the Sikh and Hindu communities gathered funds for the construction of a mosque.
If one ever talks about strengths of India as a nation, the first thing that comes in mind is its ability to be home to a number of different cultures and religions that are residing here peacefully. The quality of Indians to embrace differences and help each and everyone in a community is what that makes the secular fabric of the country shine brighter. In a similar display of communal harmony in the country, Hindu and Sikh residents of Punjab's Bhullar village are building a mosque for the village's Muslim residents.
ਅੱਜ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸੁਮੇਲ ਦੇਖਣ ਨੂੰ ਮਿਲਿਆ ਇਹ ਬੜਾ ਕਿਤੇ ਕਿਤੇ ਮਿਲਦਾ ਹੈ. ਮੁਹੰਮਦੀ ਮਸਜਿਦ ਭਲੂਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਦਾ ਨੀਂਹ ਪੱਥਰ ਰੱਖਣ ਜਾ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ, ਉਸ ਮਸਜਿਦ ਦੀ ਤਾਮੀਰ ਕਰਨ ਜਾ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ ਅਤੇ ਮਸ਼ਵਰਾ ਸਲਾਹ ਫੰਡ ਇਕੱਠਾ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰਾ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ।
The village is located in the Moga district of Punjab and constitutes of 7 gurudwaras and 2 temples. There was a mosque that existed here before partition but now stands in ruins. Although the village has only 4 Muslim families, Sikh and Hindu members of the village decided that a mosque should be constructed here. Villagers have gone out of their ways to donate sums of money that ranged from 100 rupees to around 1 lakh rupees.
ਜਦੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਦੇਖਿਆ ਕਿ ਸਾਰੇ ਦਾ ਸਾਰਾ ਪਿੰਡ ਸਾਡੇ ਨਾਲ ਮੋਢਾ ਲਾ ਕੇ ਖੜਾ ਤੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰਾ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਅੰਦਰ ਇਕੱਠ ਪੂਰਾ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ, ਪੂਰਾ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰਾ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਭਰਿਆ ਸੀ ਤੇ ਇੱਥੋਂ ਤੱਕ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੱਲਾਸ਼ੇਰੀ ਤਾਂ ਬਹੁਤ ਮਿਲ ਰਹੀ ਸੀ। ਪਰ ਜਦੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਮਸਜਿਦ ਲਈ ਪੈਸੇ ਇਕੱਠੇ ਕਰਦੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਉਸ ਗੱਲ ਨੂੰ ਐਲਾਨ ਕਰਦੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਵੀ ਜਿਹਨੇ ਵੀ ਆਪਣਾ ਸਹਿਯੋਗ ਪਾਉਣਾ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਧਾਰਮਿਕ ਜਗ੍ਹਾ ਹੈ, ਇੱਕ ਬੰਦੇ ਦੇ ਸਹਿਯੋਗ ਨਾਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਬਣਦੀ, ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਸਹਿਯੋਗ ਨਾਲ ਬਣਦੀ ਹੈ। ਤਕਰੀਬਨ ਮੁਸਲਿਮ ਭਾਈਚਾਰਾ ਵੀ ਬਹੁਤ ਜ਼ਿਲ੍ਹਿਆਂ 'ਚੋਂ ਇਕੱਠੇ ਹੋਏ ਸੀ, ਉੱਥੇ ਆਏ ਹੋਏ ਸੀਗੇ, ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਵੀ ਦਿਲ ਬੜੇ ਗਦਗਦ ਹੋ ਰਹੇ ਸੀ।
This remarkable gesture by Hindu and Sikh community members to help their Muslim brethren in worshipping without hardship serves as a wonderful example of secularism, fraternity, religious tolerance and unity in diversity.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Mana Patel made India's Olympic history by becoming the country's first female swimmer to qualify for Tokyo 2020 after world governing body FINA approved her participation under the universality quota following some strong performances in European meets in the last 3 months. The universality quota allows one female and male participant each from a country to take part in the Olympics provided no other swimmer from the same gender qualifies for the competition through the normal process. Despite not securing a slot through qualification time, Mana said her key focus is about gaining Olympic experience and putting her country on the world sporting stage.
I'm very, very thrilled. I'm honored and humbled to represent my country at the Olympics this year. But I believe this is just the beginning for me and there's a long, long way to go. Many more medals to win for India.
The 21-year-old will compete in women's 100-meter backstroke event, joining men's athlete Sajan Prakash and Srihari Natarajan to represent the South Asian nation in Japan at the Summer Games. The Tokyo Olympics, postponed for a year due to the COVID-19 pandemic, are scheduled to start on July 23. Youths of Kashmir's border villages thronged a recruitment drive conducted by the police for its special border battalion. Jammu and Kashmir Police's border battalion is formed with the special purpose of inclusivity and they will be trained to stop infiltration raids and cross-border drugs and weapon smuggling.
ये augment करेगा J&K police को border areas में जो लोग रहते हैं उनकी representation थोड़ी कम थी J&K force में, so government has decided कि वो exclusively इन लोगों को recruitment देगा जो border areas में बहुत सारी इनको difficulties है, so it's a sort of help to those border people.
हमने यहाँ constable border battalion की भर्ती देखने के लिए आए, इंशाल्लाह हम यहाँ पे running हमारी अच्छी भी रही और हमें उम्मीद है कि हम select हो जाएंगे.
तो क्यों आप police में भर्ती होंगे?
हम इसीलिए हम police में भर्ती होना चाहते हैं कि हम देश की सेवा करें. कोई भी हमारे देश में घुसपैठिए कोई भी आ सकते हैं, क्योंकि हम इसको अंदर आना नहीं देंगे अपने देश से. अपने देश में सुरक्षित रखने की मतलब हमारी यही चिंता है.
Youngsters were happy to have been getting more employment opportunities even in the most remote areas of the country. An idol maker in eastern West Bengal state finds pride in exporting handmade idols of Hindu warrior goddess Durga made from fiberglass to foreign countries. Idol maker Mintu Pal, who hails from Kolkata city, said despite the pandemic he received 2 orders from New Jersey and Berlin each, which will be priced at around $2,000.
Har saal hamare idhar Kolkata Kumartoli se videshon mein fiberglass ka Durga murti jata hai. Is saal bhi मेरे को 2 ऑर्डर मिला है, एक न्यू जर्सी चला गया, यूएसए, और एक तो बर्लिन जाएगा, अभी जाने के लिए तैयार है। ये टोटल फाइबर ग्लास का बना हुआ है और इसका कॉस्ट कम से कम 1.5 लाख के ऊपर ही आता है।
Artisans in West Bengal state are famous for creating larger-than-life idols of Hindu warrior goddesses that are worshipped during the grand Hindu festival of Durga Puja or festival dedicated to the goddess.
India is a country where Sufism has not just flourished but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. Even today, the teachings of these saints inform the lives of people and act as a guiding force for them. One such darga is that of Hazrat Syed Shah Miran Husseini Baghdadi, which is visited by people of all faiths to seek the blessings of holy saints.
Situated in the Hyderabad district of Telangana, the shrine of Sufi saint Hazrat Syed Shah Miran Husseini Baghdadi has served as a synodger of communal harmony for generations, which is thronged by a large number of devotees every day from across the nation, irrespective of their religion. Regarded as one of the greatest Sufi saints, Hazrat Syed Shah Miran Husseini throughout his life spread the message of Sufism and peace. Devotees cutting across religious lines visit this dargah to offer their prayers to the Sufi saint.
ఇక్కడ 3 ఇయర్స్ నుంచి ఉంటున్నాము. ఇక్కడ దర్గాకి వస్తుంటాము అప్పుడప్పుడు. ఇక్కడికి వస్తే చాలా మంచి అయింది. మా ఫ్యామిలీ కానీ ఇంకా ఫ్రెండ్స్ కానీ చాలామంది వస్తుంటాము అప్పుడప్పుడు, మనసు బాగాలేనప్పుడు, ఇంకా కష్టాల్లో ఉన్న ఎవరైనా ఉంటే కూడా ఇక్కడ దర్గా ఉంది, ఇక్కడ చూస్తారు, మంచిగా ఉంటుందని చెప్పి ఈ పబ్లిక్ని రమ్మని చెప్పేస్తాను. నేను కూడా చాలామంది ఫ్రెండ్స్ని తీసుకొచ్చాను ఇక్కడ. ఇక్కడ హిందూ ముస్లిం భేదాలంటూ ఏం లేవు, అందరూ హిందువులు ముస్లింలు అందరూ కలిసే ఉంటారు, అందరూ అన్నదమ్ములు అక్కచెల్లెల్లా ఉంటారు. ఇక్కడ ఇప్పటివరకు అయితే నేను చూస్తున్నప్పటి నుండి ఎలాంటి గొడవలు లేవు సార్. ఇక్కడ చాలా మంచి అనిపిస్తుంది, మనసు ప్రశాంతంగా ఉంటుంది. ఎన్ని కష్టాల్లో వాళ్ళు కూడా ఇక్కడ వచ్చి
commonly known as Al Baghdadi Baba among locals, the 395 years old dargah is visited and revered by people of all faiths. It is believed that the saint fulfills the wishes of all and nobody returns empty handed from here.
Ab shafa hai aur hindu muslim aisa kuch hai nahi, koi bhi aao dargah mein darshan kar leke ja sakta.
Ji abhi aap kitne saal se yahan pe aa rahe
ho? Kam se kam 3-4 saal se aa. कोविड के टाइम पे तो कोई आया नहीं, मैं भी अभी आया जी. अभी पूरी तरह से खुला नहीं ना, अभी तो लोग आज ही खोले. अभी सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग मेंटेन कर रहे हैं वो लोग, एक के बाद में एक जाके आए, बाद में दूसरे को छोड़ रहे.
Since ages, the Sufi saints like Hazrat Syed Shah Miran Husseini have propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country, and their teachings are still playing a significant role in strengthening the threat of secularism.
And now we will meet an artist from New Delhi who has been spreading awareness regarding plastic waste management by ways of his creative pieces of art. Take a look.
The bane of plastic has been threatening the planet since quite a long time. Each year, International Plastic Free Day is observed on 3rd of July around the world, with the idea of doing away with hazardous plastic waste that pollutes the earth. Artists around the world are constantly trying to educate commoners to avoid the use of plastic by ways of their artworks and creations. One such artist is Manveer Singh from New Delhi, who collected 250 kgs of multi-layer plastic waste to turn it into various artworks.
मैंने प्लास्टिक को अपने कलर के तौर पे उसको यूज करने का एक डिसीजन लिया कि मैं इसको क्यों ना एज ए कलर की तरह यूज करूं. उससे जो मेरा जो पर्पज है वो भी क्लियर होगा कि प्लास्टिक को एक कलर की तरह मैं यूज करूंगा और लोगों को भी अवेयर करूंगा.
Singh started its innovative eco-friendly work in April 2018 and has till now sold 3 of his artworks in foreign countries, in countries like Abu Dhabi and Germany. An art teacher by profession, Singh wanted to contribute towards environment conservation. and started his new venture, shifting from normal paintings to creative artworks. Singh converts non-biodegradable plastics into innovative pieces of artworks that are beautiful to look at. His work have also been displayed at many places like Abu Dhabi National Exhibition Center, Museum of Goa and more.
अभी तक पिछले तीन साल में मैंने करीब 250 केजी जो एमएलपी है मल्टीलेड प्लास्टिक है वो इकट्ठा किया है और इससे करीब मैंने 11 भी काम बनाए हैं। ये अभी मेरा नेक्स्ट अपकमिंग है, 12 काम हो जाएंगे इसके बाद। और शुरुआत में मेरे लिए काफ़ी डिफ़िकल्ट था प्लास्टिक इकट्ठा करना भी, क्योंकि मैं अपने दोस्तों और आसपास के जो रिलेटिव हैं उन्हीं से ही इकट्ठा कर रहा था, और अकेले लोगों के बार घर जाना और उसको इकट्ठा करना भी डिफ़िकल्ट था, तो मुझे और ज़्यादा कंजप्शन करना था, काफ़ी ज़्यादा अमाउंट में मुझे प्लास्टिक चाहिए थी, तो इसके लिए मैंने स्कूल को कॉन्टेक्ट किया।
Plastic bags are used for 25 minutes on average, and it takes for 500 years to a century for plastic bags to disintegrate. Every minute, a million plastic bags are used around the world.
Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section World in Focus.
Japanese horseradish, also known as wasabi, has fiery taste and is an important ingredient in Japanese food. In Azumino, Nagano wasabi is used as ice topping. Nissei introduces hot soft ice cream.
Wasabi soft cream wa 1984年に発売しております。ですから今からですね、だいたい40年くらい前に販売したものです。昨年からですね、大王プレミアムわさびソフトクリームという新たな商品を開発しました。でこちらはですね、先ほど説明しました今までにあった本わさびソフトクリームに、すりおろした生わさびをトッピングしております。
ちゃんとわさびと甘さと美味しいですよツンとして、独特の味わいです。はい、
思った以上に甘くないというか、アイスだけどアイスっぽくもないし、なんかわさびの感じも全然ずっとくる感じじゃなく、なんかすっきり食べられますね。
Daiyo Wasabi Farm was established in the year 1915 in Japan's largest wasabi farm, covering an area of 15 hectares. The farm grows the best quality Japanese horseradishes. The farm has been attractively developed for tourists with walking trails between fields. Wasabi can only be grown in distilled water, and Azumino is blessed with sparkling clean spring water fed by snowmelt from Japanese Alps.
Wasabi には湧き水が非常に大事でして、でこの地はですね、2メートルくらい地面を掘ると湧き水が自然と湧いてきます。でその湧き水を使って、わさび栽培をしております。
The ice cream stall is popular among visitors. While the Daiyo Wasabi Farm has been a favorite of Japanese tourists who admire it for its picturesque beauty, the farm is also famous for the wide array of culinary delights offered by its shops. At a height of 21.16 meters, 3.5 meters higher than the previous record holder, the world's new tallest sandcastle was unveiled in Denmark last week. The sandcastle built in Blokhus in northwest Denmark broke the Guinness World Record, previously held by a sandcastle made in Germany in 2019, which was 17.66 meters.
We started with Corona on top. And we give it a crown because Corona means crown. It's like nice and double. But we give it also a crown because it's ruling. It's ruling our lives everywhere. It tells you what to do. It tells you to wear a mouth protection. It tells you to, you know, to stay away from your family and not go to the nice places. Don't do the activities. Stay home.
Dutch designer Wilfred Stigjer said the Corona pandemic had inspired the sandcastle. At top of the castle, he puts a coronavirus as a crown to illustrate how the virus is ruling our world and not allowing us to do what we want to do. Like many other big sand castles, it is made as a triangle in order not to collapse, and a wooden construction was erected around it so that around 30 artists could cut the figures in the sand. Around 4.8 tons of sand were used to build the sand castle.
I'm amazed, but I'm always amazed when the sculptures are making the sand sculptures. But this year it's amazing. It's very, very, very beautiful artwork you've never seen before.
The sand is made up of 10% clay for it to stick better and when the sand castle is done. And an extra layer of glue is put on to make it last through most of winter. The Guinness World Record was measured by an authorized surveyor and signed by witnesses and will be in the book's next edition. The Sand Sculpture Festival in Blokhus takes place every summer. Yamba Dam, located in Nagano-hara, Gunma Prefecture. It was opened in 2020. It is built on the Agatsuma River. It took around 70 years to build a dam and it stands 131 meters high. This dam helps in flood control and irrigation and is also gaining popularity as a tourist destination because of being surrounded by mountains and a lake.
このダムの上に一般の観光客の方が入れるようになりまして、それからたくさんの方が観光でいらっしゃっています。今ですね、湖を使った観光、例えば水陸両用バスですとか船を浮かべたり、あとカヌーやカヤックなどの水上アクティビティも楽しむことができる、ダムになっております。
Local operators have also launched an amphibious bus service that gives a tour of the lake. The idea of using infrastructures like dams, tunnels and power stations as a tourist site is becoming popular in Japan.
まあそこでいろいろ見るとやはり観光地があるなっていうのがこの向こう側にビジターセンターみたいなとこあったんで道の駅ですかそこでマップを見てるとこちらもなんか観光地だったんで。
Just close to the dam, the municipality has built market where tourist bus stops. There are restaurants, souvenir shops offering sweets and gifts along with local fresh agricultural produce.
この地域のちょっと奥の方には、嬬恋のキャベツですとか、北軽井沢のレタス、トウモロコシ、そういったものが高原野菜がいっぱいございますんで、そういったものを使った直売所の方ではダム焼きなんていう、
This huge industrial infrastructure facility is a smart idea that contributes to tourism and reviving the local economy.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@nin.com. I'm your host Karim, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.